Okay, let's go.
Hello, Karakseen. This is Dr. Fazila. Please come to my house.
Talking about stretch, align, and move, today we are going to delve into the world of holistic physiotherapy, sound healing, and taking care of oneself. My name is Fatima Ali Safri, and welcome to the 10th episode of Karakseen, Karak Chai with Karak Baatein. Today, we have a privilege to talk with Dr. Fazila. She's a renowned physiotherapist and the founder of Mind Body Therapy. It's a holistic wellness platform. Thank you so much, Dr. Fazila, for taking out your time and having us.
The pleasure is all mine, Fatima. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. So, Doctor, many of us know you from your success stories, mashallah. I want you to introduce yourself.
Okay, so you know my name by now. My name is Dr. Fazila. I am a holistic physiotherapist. So what this holistic physiotherapist means, I have a comprehensive management technique where I combine the physical, mental, and the emotional aspect of the pain. So I have a technique where I talk with the patients, I go into the depth of their pain and all, and then I find out what basically needs to be done. So that is one part of me. The second is I combine the physical part of physiotherapy with the mental part by the sound meditation. So what is sound meditation? How does it help? That we will be talking further.
I have been following you on social media since a very long time.
Okay.
I love how you have been posting various beneficial videos on your Instagram, especially the initiative that you did in Ramadan.
Yeah.
Posting videos about basic flexibility of joints, mobility, and of course sound healing. Then there was a lot of self-love.
Yeah.
So let's talk about these topics one by one. Let's start with posture.
Okay.
So there is a term called ergonomics.
Yes.
So let's start with this. And of course, you also provide a corporate service, right?
Yes.
So I want to know about all this.
Okay. So let's start with what do you mean by ergonomics? So ergonomics means it's the way you design your workspace in such a way that you don't land up into aches and pains. Okay.
Okay.
So basically, we make the working environment worker friendly.
Yes.
Okay, that is the simplest I can explain what ergonomics is. Now, basically it is about taking care of your posture. Okay, So definitely we do the external arrangements, that is one part, but we have to also align ourselves to that environment.
Okay.
Okay, so nowadays what is happening is, as you know, because of the social media, okay, because of the phone.
Yes.
Because of the digital world that is more and more progressing.
True.
People are becoming more and more sedentary, right?
Correct.
So because of that sedentary lifestyle, what happens is the first thing that it affects is your posture, the way you sit. Mostly you'll be seeing people, you know, sagging and sitting,
yes,
using their phone with their head down, you know. So those things on long-term basis affects your muscle flexibility, mobility, your strength, and it then affects your cardiovascular health, your mental health. So it's all related with each other.
Right.
So that's how I start my physiotherapy. So whoever comes to me, the first thing I ask them is, what is their job profile?
So what is that?
So what is their job profile means? What do they do? Their work is more of sitting, their work is more of standing, their work is more of driving, bending, lifting, what it is first. Based on that, the first thing in the first session that they will learn is how to use their body properly in their work. Okay, in spite of their pain and all, that's totally fine. That I am anyways going to take care. But
yes,
how do you bend? How do you lift? How do you correct your posture? How do you put cues for yourself so that again and again there is a reminder that you have to take care of your posture? So by the end of 5 or 10 sessions, what happens? It becomes a habit for them.
Right. So doctor, can you show us some simple tips and tricks that can be followed to take care of our posture on our day-to-day basis?
Yeah, sure. So this is my favorite, which I usually teach all my patients. So what you need to do is, so we start with the head first, okay? So remember that you are wearing a crown on your head, okay? That's an imaginary crown that you are wearing all the time till you are awake. Okay, so what that means is that your head should not go like this, or your head should not go like this, okay?
Okay.
Or your head should not be poked, because otherwise the crown will fall. Okay. So the simplest technique is, there is a crown on your head and you have to balance it all the time till you are awake. That's the first thing. The second thing is your chin. Okay, so basically what happens right now is, either you are completely down, or either you are poked, or either you are hunched. So what happens to the chin is, it is poked forward. Now how do you correct it? You have corrected the crown. Now imagine your hand as your favorite fruit. So for example, for me it is mango.
Okay.
So this is my favorite fruit, mango. What I will do is, I'll put it between the chin and chest. Okay. Now I don't have to crush the fruit. I just have to hold it
tightly.
Yeah. So when you sandwich it between your chin and chest, you will see that you have already aligned the chin properly. You will see a very, very subtle movement behind your neck.
Yes.
Okay. So basically what I'm trying to do is, I'm not trying to look down. I'm just looking straight. Remember, you have the crown on your head. So the crown is there. Then your favorite fruit is there. Okay, mm-hmm. So you have aligned the head and the chin. The third thing is your collarbone. As I told you, if the head goes forward, the chin goes forward, even the shoulders will come forward.
Right.
So we have to align the shoulder as well. So crown, mango, and now a smiling collarbone. Remember the collarbone. So this is your collarbone.
Right.
So your collarbone has to be always smiling. Not laughing, it is smiling. Okay. So if I do it correctly.
This is laughing.
Yeah, so that is laughing. That way people will not do it also. That's a very military posture.
True.
So what we need to do is a smiling collarbone. That's it. So if I do these three things together, crown, fruit, and the collarbone, you will see instantly that you are much taller, you are much confident, and you are breathing quite well.
Yeah. Doctor, am I doing it correctly?
Yeah. So crown on your head.
Yes.
Your
the
chin.
The fruit is here. And,
yeah. And your
my collarbones are smiling.
Yeah. So now you see, you were sitting like this, little
right.
hunched. As soon as I told you, you automatically straightened the spine. So that is a repercussion that will happen. So when you fix the top, the down will automatically start pulling you up.
So doctor, healing for every body is different, and you keep on mentioning about the holistic approach, and you have recently started your own venture, that is mind body therapy. So tell us about it and how you started it and how is it going?
Yeah, I partnered with my fitness coach and my nutrition coach, and I started the mind body therapy. So the concept of mind body therapy has been there in my mind from quite a good amount of years, and I have been trying it in some other way to give life to it, but last year I was able to successfully launch it, and that is what mind body therapy is.
So what comes under this banner?
Yeah, so under mind body therapy, what we have done is a holistic wellness platform,
right?
So we have made different approaches for schools, for the teachers,
okay,
for the moms to be. So for those who are, you know, trying to conceive, or who are already pregnant, or who are in their postpartum phase,
right?
Then for sports wellness, because here you see that there are so many sports academies that are going on, but those are more on a recreational basis. So how do you plan in such a way that you guide the kids right from a very young age about nutrition, about their stretchings, about their mobility and postures and things like that?
Uh-huh.
Then we have the recent one is for the corporates. So for the corporates, what we want is that each corporate, whether they are small or big firm, doesn't matter, they should have well-being for their employees right from the beginning. So right from the designing stage, they should have ergonomics in place, they should have, you know, those health checkups, the fitness, the nutrition guidelines, and everything, you know, on a regular basis, rather than doing it in a fragmented way, where, you know, once in a year, you just call somebody and get a exercise done. That is of no use. So we have made a program where we are with them for 3 and 6 months. So that is the corporate wellness. And we are going to do is about emotional well-being. So we are going to, you know, call different guests and all who are into emotional healing, emotional wellness, because that is also a field which is much more into boom right now, in sense. People are more going into anxiety, depression, even teenagers, all those the disorders about eating disorders and all, they are all on rise because of the world that we are living in right now. So just to address those things, we will be running, you know, a content on emotional wellness on our page for the next month. So this is what comes under mind-body therapy.
So what can we find in this content?
So for the emotional well-being, what you can see is how there are different ways that you can navigate to, you know, release your emotional traumas that you have. Okay, the emotional pent-ups that you have. I'll give you a simple example. So basically, I see more of female patients, right? So when the female patients come to me, for example, they come with the neck pain. Now, I know that every pain has an emotional aspect also to it. Nobody comes to me like 2-3 days ke pehle hi mujhe pain hua. No, they will be like, no, from 1 month, 2 months, or maybe from 2 to 3 years, they are having this pain constantly.
Sahi.
So when, as soon as I say it is chronic, it means there is some emotional baggage to it. So then I start talking with them, you know, simple and simple words. Okay, how is your life? What do you do? You know, things. So then they start opening up. So that is my technique of, you know, asking them. And sometimes they open up by themselves. Sometimes they start crying when they come for the session. So, you know, that is a release that they are doing.
Wow.
Sometimes when I do release for the upper body, I have certain techniques of releasing through my hands. So when I do that, they will automatically start telling me. Okay. So now what do I do is sometimes I tell them, okay, fine. I refer them to a particular specialist. Okay, fine. You go and see them because this doesn't come in my parameter. I cannot help you. Or if I can help them, I do my sound meditation or I give them some affirmations to repeat on a regular basis. So this is the way I do the full treatment with them. So that's what I will be showing in the content that we have planned in the next month.
Wow, this is so interesting. Yeah. I wish you all the best for this.
Thank you so much.
How can people contact you for this one?
Through my social media pages. I'm available as Stretch Align Move on Instagram, also as Mind Body Therapy Official. So you have all our contact details over there, or you can go to Karak Scene on the episode 10th and connect with me.
I see you as a very big promoter of mental well-being.
Yeah.
And you have been talking about sound healing. I'm very curious to know about it more.
Okay. So sound healing or meditation, as I put it as, is a meditation guided by sound. Okay, we have different instruments that I use for meditation, for guiding that sound meditation. And I will just tell you the basic idea how it works. Okay, so it's very scientific. Now see, what happens is, right now, because again, coming back to social media and all those things, we are more into a fight and flight response. What is fight and flight? Now, in the earlier generation, the fight and flight was used when as a survival mechanism. So for example, agar koi sher aata hai aapke samne, fine, what is the first thing you will do? You are not going to stand and see the tiger or the lion. You're going to run. That's a very instinctive thing that the body will do. So that is your fight and flight, right? Now, in today's world, where even for small things, we are so much hyping ourselves, ke, you know, are ye karna hai, are ye bacche ko ye karna hai, ya mujhe work pe jana hai. So for every tiny things, we are just, you know, torturing ourselves.
We worry
too much. Yeah. So that is exactly what is the fight and flight. So we are always in that state right now, in today's generation. That is why we are not able to relax. Fine. And that is what leads to all the other conditions, the other diseases that you name it. Okay. Now, through sound, what we do is we activate that parasympathetic system. So parasympathetic system is the relaxation system of the body. Okay. Now, how does it do is, so I'll give you a very simple example. Now, when you are sleeping, okay, so there is an initial stage where you are still awake, where you know what is going around. There is a second phase where you are, you know, sinking into that deep sleep. Fine. And the third stage is the deep sleep. You will not know what is happening.
Yes.
Okay. Now, the second phase is known, medically it is known as the alpha state.
Okay.
So, beta state is your state, the state that we are in right now. Alpha state is that, the second state. Now, through sound meditation, through the process of entrainment, we put that person into that alpha state. Okay, it will automatically happen because the body will be so relaxed, you will automatically go into that level. And when you hit that level, there is something known as self-healing mechanism, which is there in the body, which is there in everybody. Our body is a fantastic machine. It has that self-healing mechanism. As soon as you relax, it will activate. When it activates, it will heal each and everything that it thinks is injured in the body. That is why right now the doctors and all, wherever you go, they will ask you first, what is your sleep pattern? What time do you sleep? Do you sleep properly? Do you have a sound sleep? Okay, because sleep is very important for healing you. So through that meditation, what we do is we activate those senses and we give the healing mechanism to the body. Okay, so this is the scientific basis of how the healing and how through sound meditation we help people. Journey started before 2 to 3 years of sound meditation. I did all the courses, I became a sound meditation facilitator, and now I combine it with my physiotherapy.
Wow. Yeah. So you experience it,
yes,
and then you learn it. And
yeah. So in that, I have also healed myself. So that's where it comes that when you heal somebody, you also heal a part of
you. So how do you merge it with your physiotherapy practice?
Okay. So as I told you earlier also that I will come to know if there is some emotional baggage to the patient.
Sorry.
Now, that benefit of doubt I have from last so many years of experience that I have. So when I know that... through my affirmations that I give them, or through the therapy, or through other lifestyle changes that I've told them, it is not helping them, I will introduce them to sound meditation. So I will tell them, okay, let's do one session, and I feel that this is the issue with you. Let's do this meditation and see how you feel. Or else what I will do is, as soon as they come for the second, third session, I will start the session itself with like a 10 minutes of guided meditation, just to calm them down. Or I will combine it, meditation with the breath work. So like what we just did for some time. So some breathing exercise to calm themselves, to calm their nerves, because they sometimes come with so much of anxiety with the diagnosis that they got from the doctor. So that's the way I channelize their energies. So once they connect with it, they come back to me again. They're like, no, we want the full session. We don't want only 10 minutes. We want the full session. So
how that's long how, is the full session?
It depends on the, how many parts you have to heal. So that we will come to know when we start the sound meditation. So sometimes even 30 minutes is enough, sometimes 45 minutes, sometimes 1 hour. Because as I told you, the patient will sleep when we do the session. Or it will automatically happen. They will just go into a sleep. So then we don't disturb them. Then we just wait for them to come back to an active state. So that's how the session timing changes. Yeah, even the number of sessions, we tell them that according to me, this is what you need. Now, when they connect, they will automatically keep on coming back again and again.
This is so impressive. Like, I really wish that, you know, if I can also have a session with you.
Yeah,
is
sure.
Is it possible?
Sure. Let us try.
Let's go.
Some of the few instruments that I use for sound meditation, these are the basic ones. This is known as the Tibetan singing bowls. It is made of different metals, and all the bowls that you see, they are of different sizes and they have got different frequencies when you strike them. And they are used for either in combination or separately as well.
Amazing sound session. I mean, I was trying to disconnect from my thoughts, which is a very big challenge for me of lately. It was like, I was floating. I felt I was like weightless. And you know, the way she was explaining, and the best part was when the goal was so close to my mind, my head, the sound, the vibrations that I felt, I've never felt that before. I had tears in my eyes. She said that, you know, you have to feel that you are in the womb of your mother, and that was so nice.
So this was all about how Dr. Fazila is professionally. Now we want to know, what is the inspiration behind your personality?
Okay, so talking about inspiration, I take inspiration from each and every person that I meet. My professional life, I really dedicate it to my principal ma'am. She's no more right now, but the thing that I take from her is, how do you respect yourself as what you are in your profession, what you bring on table, and you know that aura of what you say is not something, you know, just randomly. You know what you are speaking, you know what you are bringing on the table, you know who you are as a physiotherapist. So that acumen is from her, so I dedicate that to her. So this is how people are all around me inspire me in some or the other.
So doctor, there are times, you know, when, you know, things are always positive and then even the affirmations work, but कभी कभी लाइफ में ऐसे लो पॉइंट्स आते हैं कि देन यू नो इवन आई फील दैट दीज पॉजिटिव अफर्मेशंस डू नॉट ऑल्सो वर्क एंड यू आर लाइक यू नो यू आर इन अ स्टेट और आई कैन से अ वेरी नेगेटिव स्टेट सो वॉट इज योर गो टू मंत्रा और द कोटेशन दैट यू नो यू थिंक अबाउट एंड देन यू फॉलो एंड यू हील योरसेल्फ
फ्रैंकली स्पीकिंग the quotes and the mantras keeps on changing according to our mindset or according to what stage we are in. Or and as a woman, we keep on having different cycles.
Correct.
So, you know, it keeps on changing. But when I am at my low, what I do is I have a handful of people that I go to. Okay. And they are always there for me to, you know, calm me down and to again put me on track, to ground me. If they are not available, what I do is I just sit with myself. I love to sit with myself. So even if you leave me alone, I am very comfortable with me. So then I have my self-talks. Then I have all my the gratitude that I have learned through sound meditation. So that is the biggest change in me through sound meditation. So small things also that you have. So I just close my eyes and I think of all the things that I have. Physical, jo bhi materialistic thing hai, ya how the healing hand that you have, so whatever it is, the body, the correct functioning body that you have, whatever it is, I just divert my attention to those things and that itself lifts me up. So this is how I put myself on track again. So there are different ways that you can let out your emotions whenever you are anxious or whenever panic attacks hits you or whenever you want to, you know, really cry out. Just cry it out. Don't worry what people will feel or what are you going to feel or whatever it is. Don't keep that judging on the side and just cry it out. That's it. Secondly, what you can do is you write down all your negative emotions and don't read that paper again. Just burn it out. A technique which was showed to me when I was doing my sound meditation, that my teacher told me that take a pillow and be in a space where nobody is around. And you just punch those pillows so hard with all the negative emotions that you have or any grudges, any guilt, anything that is negative for you. Just punch it out. Just punch it out on the bag or on the pillow and remove it. And keep on doing that practice on a regular basis. I'll give you an example. Before a few months, during one of our meetup, what had happened was there was a large social gathering and we were on duty over there, and there was a teenage girl. She just started crying and, you know, being breathless, and her friend was there with her, and luckily we were like doctors on duty, so they called us that can you just help this lady, she is just crying. So I now there was nothing which I can do because it was a big social gathering. So what simply I did was I just sat with her. I took her hand in my hand and I told her that don't think I'm a doctor or you don't know me or anything like that. You just cry it out. Just cry. I am not going to judge you and nobody around is going to judge you. Just cry it out. I didn't even ask her what was the problem, what happened, and you know, I asked her friend also, can we contact anybody? She's like, no, it's that lady only told, no, don't tell to anyone. It's okay. You just need a hand. You just need a ear to listen. And you just need a shoulder to cry on. So that's it. That's how we calmed her down in that situation. And she was quite happy after that.
So beautiful, whatever you said. I want to know more about your take on self-love.
Okay, so self-love, again, it's the first thing, it's not being about egoistic or selfish. So if people think that self-love is that, so for me, it is not that. For me, self-love is how disciplined I am. Okay, how committed I am to whatever responsibilities I take. Okay, how committed I am that I take care of myself. The first thing in the morning that I do is I do my prayers, I do my meditation, I do my exercises. I never skip that. And then I have my own kind of food, nutritious food that I take. So that for me is self-love. Okay. The other thing is the boundaries that you make. Fine. So you know when to say no. Okay. You know your the people that you can trust. You know that you don't have to take comments from each and every one. Okay. Even if they speak, it is fine. It is not going to come to you.
But you don't have to take it on.
Yes. Right? So that is self-love for me. So that I really, really, really tell each and every person, especially to women, because I have seen that they are somebody who will keep themselves last. So I really promote that to each and every patient that comes to me, that give yourself a priority. Give yourself a priority means at least start taking care of yourself, your body. The guilt, the anger that you have for anybody in your family, try to acknowledge that, remove that. There are different sources how you can remove that. And you will see that you will start loving yourself, what you do. And because of that, even your family will start respecting you for that. Okay. Start disciplining yourself. You know where you are lacking, right? Okay. So, wo bahar se pehle start nahi hoga, wo andar se pehle start hoga. You discipline yourself first. First, I disciplined myself. I have to do all these things for myself. ओके वो जैसे जैसे मैं करने लगी वैसे वैसे ये एटीट्यूड अपने आप ही आ गया एंड अपने आप ही पीपल स्टार्टेड अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट नॉट इन अ नेगेटिव वे ओके नॉट इन अ नेगेटिव वे दे नो दैट आई एम बिजी दे नो दैट आई हैव वर्क बट व्हेन दे नीड मी आई विल ऑलवेज बी देयर विद देम
So as we conclude today's episode, of course, we have learned a lot of important things from sound healing, taking care of ourselves, of course, ergonomics. Dr. Fazila, do you want to say something in the end?
Just one line that take care of yourself, make yourself a priority, and everything else will fall into place on its own. Thank you.
That's wonderful. So I hope you love today's episode. Please follow Dr. Fazila, Mind Body Therapy, Karak Seen on Instagram, and yes, remember the crown, the fruit, and the smile of the
collarbones.
Please take care of yourself. It is me, Fatima Ali Safri, signing off. Ma'assalama.